let's talk about centrifugal pump. So centrifugal pump is based on vertex flow, forced vertex flow. So in forced vertex flow, an external torque is required to rotate the fluid like this. There will be some fluid in vessel and we will be forcing this vessel to rotate such that this fluid itself is having a rotation, and that can be called as a forced vertex flow. So here, since we are rotating the given vessel, the angular velocity of fluid inside this vessel will be constant. So omega will be constant, so that the velocity of a point from the center is given by this V is given by omega r. Now, rise in pressure because of this vertex flow. As we know that the velocity here is more and here the velocity is less, because of increase in velocity there will be a change in pressure, and that rise in pressure is called V square by 2g, or when we are rotating the pressure towards this side will be more, so that pressure is V square by 2g. So in centrifugal pump we are using this concept here. The parts of centrifugal pump are impeller, casing, foot valve and delivery pipe. Impeller means the blades, and casing means this is some type of casing where the area of cross section is increasing, and then it is foot valve. Foot valve is present here, and then there is, along with the suction pipe, then there is delivery pipe. What happens is here it will be filled with water. When it rotates, the water will be forced to move from this point to the in radially outward direction. So here, as there will be a rise in pressure V square by 2g. That is, when water moves from this side to another side, there will be a rise in pressure given by V square by 2g. And because of this rise in pressure, so the pressure head increases. Because of this, the water will be forced to move from this place through the delivery pipe to a particular height. Now, casing. Casing is having an increase in area of cross section, because as water moves through this casing, because of this increase in area of cross section, the pressure energy increases. Now, delivery pipe. Delivery pipe is having a valve called delivery valve. And what happens is, when water moves up, this valve opens. So it enables the water to move up, and it also prevents the downward flow of water through the delivery pipe. Then in suction pipe, there is a foot valve and also a strainer. This strainer helps to avoid those impurities from water, and also this foot valve, again same as that of delivery valve, it helps for the upward motion. It opens by the upward motion of the water, and also it prevents the downward motion of water through the suction pipe. So in total, centrifugal pump works on vertex flow, and also the main parts are impeller, casing, foot